Joining us now in the player escape room is a young woman who has enjoyed an incredible successful season with winning the double. Please welcome to the show Sydney FC's rising star, Sarah Hunter. Hey, Sarah, how are you? Welcome to the show.
Oh, thanks for having me. I'm feeling pretty good this morning. So, yeah, happy to be here.
It's great to have a bit of silverware on the show. So it adds a little bit of bling and a little bit of class to the show. So we're super excited to have you here.
Yeah, no, it always makes it a bit more special having a medal. So, yeah, no, it's really good.
Do I even need to ask how you are? You must be on cloud nine. Have you been celebrating since Sunday's victory? How is everything?
Yeah, I think the game was so amazing, and then the celebrations after were even better, I think. So, I've been celebrating with the team and then obviously taking some time to reflect sort of this last day and, yeah, still smiling, you know, catching myself with, forgetting about it and then realising, looking at my lock screen because I changed it to a photo of us with the trophy. So, yeah, it's just, still can't believe it, honestly.
Yeah, amazing. What a season for the team, being crowned premiers and breaking the three-year voodoo to beat Western United and become champions, giving you the double. What do you put it down to? What did you know in pre-season? Was there a feeling in the squad, or did you start to feel it, you know, halfway through the year? What was that magic that you could feel?
Yeah, I think it was my second season at Sydney, and obviously the first season you're coming in, you don't really know, you know, if the vibe's good, if the vibe's bad. I had a great season last year, and I think this season it was just that extra year of experience, I think, coming in, that extra, disappointment from the year before. It was sort of like back-to-back losses and obviously three in a row for a few girls. So it was sort of like, okay, it's not just one time. It's becoming a few times here, so we sort of need to get that win. So, yeah, it was very focused on, you know, reaching that top level, and sort of anything else wouldn't be accepted, which it had been the last year as well. But, it was just that full focus on, you know, the journey of getting to that grand final, and, you know, the ups and downs were expected because it was a longer season. So it was just, how do we take those losses and use it to get to that grand final? I was really focused about every single lesson throughout the season is going to help us on that grand final day. And obviously it came. Ante says things, and sometimes I'm like, oh, how does he know? But most things he says comes true. So, there's a few instances during the season I was like, oh, I don't know if this is going to happen. You know, obviously we lost points and gained points with all these situations, and sort of everything he said came to fruition. So, yeah, I think he had a master plan the whole time. So it was just about making it happen.
Yeah, when you've been around the game a long time, you kind of get to be able to read things and sort of read the fortunes and the future a little bit. But tell us a little bit about, so the season, you know, pretty much in general was pretty consistent for you guys. But then obviously in the semi-final, you were beaten by Western United. How do you pick yourselves back up again? So obviously, you know, in the back of your mind, you're sitting there saying we've made three finals, which is an unbelievable achievement, but we haven't won any of those. So you start to second guess yourselves. How did you get yourselves back up, not only to get the win over the victory, but then to go into a final like this where you've absolutely smashed the opposition, with all due respect?
Yeah, I think that semi-final was a bit of a weird one. I don't know. I think maybe a bit of nerves. Obviously we'd played Western and they'd beaten us quite convincingly, actually, in the first game we played during the season, and we beat them the second time. But, yeah, I think Western are a very physical team, and they sort of came out and that's sort of, they just went for it 100%, and maybe we were a bit hesitant and, a bit of nerves. I know I've talked to a few of the younger girls as well, maybe a bit of nerves, first final for a few. So, I think looking back, I'm glad it happened because we took so many learning from that game, and going into the victory game, the second semi, we'd had good wins against them during the season. And it did take us, 89 minutes to score a goal, but there was no point during that game I thought we weren't going to win. So, sometimes in a game you just get a feeling, and I got it against Victory and I got it against Western in the grand final. So, yeah, I think, taking learnings from that first game and, you know, just having the confidence. I'm in the grand final, I was just chilling. I was having a good time because, that first semi, I think the semis are more pressure than the grand final, really, because you don't want to end your season too early. I know I'm always like, I just want to spend all the time with these girls. So that was the more pressure I felt, is having 2 weeks left of the season that I don't get to play with them and play at the grand final as well. So once you're at the grand final, it's just, you know, fun, and all my closest friends were just talking about how we're going to just enjoy it. And yeah, I think that's sort of why we came out on top, because we were focused but also having a good time.
It's a great way to look at it. Personally, it's been an amazing season for you, playing 21 games, scoring 4 goals, 3 assists, and winning a bag full of silverware, which is also nice. Can you tell us the secret behind your success? It looks like your game's gone to another level this year.
Yeah, I think I put a lot of work into my mental side of the game. I think, you know, coming from, you know, a kid sort of coming now into a sort of more mature player, you know, coming into my 20s now. Yeah, I just wanted to be that consistent player. I think that's sort of something I struggled with maybe last year, is the expectation at Sydney is very high every single game, and sort of dealing with, you know, how do I put out a performance that's acceptable at Sydney every single week? And obviously I'm still not great at it, but getting better each season and learning and taking things from Ante and all the older girls, just being able to, you know, have that confidence that, you know, you are good enough to be at this team and at this level. So yeah, that's definitely something I just, you know, try to relax a bit more and just enjoy sort of the whole experience and journey of it. So yeah, just not putting too much pressure on myself, and just trusting my instincts as well. I think I'm a very sort of thinking player, and if I have a clear head, then I'm allowed to, you know, produce sort of what I want to do. So yeah, it's just been about learning, I think, and yeah, that mental side is definitely the difference I've seen sort of in myself from the past two seasons. Yeah.
Look, it's definitely showed on the pitch, and whatever you're doing, keep doing it for the seasons to come, because it's been sensational to watch. You are only 19 and you share the same birthday as my stepdaughter, Isla. So we're already big fans in this household, but now she knows that you share the same birthday, the 7th of October. She's even more excited. But you would never know it, but with how composed you are on the pitch and how you lead by example, and even just in the example you said to me, which is I was speaking to some of the younger girls, and I'm like, you're one of the younger girls. But is there a more senior teammate that has taken you under a wing since you arrived at Sydney?
Yeah, I think even our senior girls are still like, what, 25, maybe Nat's maybe 26, like still super young.
Yeah, it's mind-blowing, isn't it?
I know, it's weird because, like, I think they're older, but, like, they're really not that much. You know, when you look at other clubs, they've got, you know, obviously great older people. But, yeah, there's that whole group that's been there for, I mean, Nat just hit 100th game, Prinny as well. So, yeah, that whole group who still young but have been there for, you know, so many seasons and had all those great experiences, I think they're all just like a bunch of, yeah, I see them all as like a collective kind of, but obviously with the individuals. I think Macca is someone, obviously both playing in the midfield together. I sort of came in and we sort of are very similar in the fact, you know, we're very competitive, and sort of our first sessions we do beach runs, and obviously Mac is one of the fittest girls on the team, so I was sort of you know, sticking with her the whole time, and I think we gained respect because Mac is usually, you know, in front of everyone by a bit, but we stuck together that beach session, and I think just that determination I think Macca and I share, and whenever we go on the pitch together, we don't even have to say anything, we just sort of lock eyes, you know, we're ready to go. And yeah, she's someone that just makes me excited to play, and she's given me so much help and been able to sort of mentor, but also she's a friend, so she's not that much older than me, but just helping with sort of the confidence side, and you know, giving me good advice. And yeah, I'm super grateful, all the girls, Courtney as well, who's so like level-minded, and you know, she's had a few up and downs throughout her career with injuries and, you know, changing clubs, and seeing how hard she's had to work to get to where she is. I mean, she's in the Matildas now, but a year ago maybe she still wasn't even there. So it's like having that patience, I think that's something I've learned from Courtney as well. So yeah, I can take different things from everyone, but they're all generally the best girls, and I'm super, super, super grateful to be a part of that group now So yeah, I just smile thinking about like going out to dinner with them because they're super great off the pitch as well.
Look, it's exciting to watch this season, and it's scary the potential in the squad considering it is still a young squad. So yeah, watch this space. But you broke one of the tribal rules of football, switching from fierce rivals Western Sydney Wanderers, but it's proved to be a genius move. So the laughs on them. Did you ruffle a few feathers at the time? Was there fans or players or anything, or is it not as big a hype as people think, and it's just you get on with business? Or was there a few little snide remarks here and there because you were going from the red and black to the sky blues?
Yeah, I think it's weird now. It feels like ages ago, but I love my time at Wanderers, and I always say that I had a great bunch of girls there as well and great coaches. So it was really hard for me to leave because, yeah, I made so many good friends there, and I still get messages from, you know, coaches and teammates at Wanderers. So, yeah, it was a tough decision, but super grateful for it now. But, yeah,
my first year at Sydney. And the right one.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that's sort of every footballer's goal is to get silverware, so definitely paid off. But yeah, I think the first year at Sydney, there's always, you know, little comments from where Ante or, you know, little things that get said about being at Wanderers. But honestly, like there's a few girls that have been at Wanderers at Sydney as well, so it's sort of, you know, not that uncommon. But yeah, it wasn't that big a deal, I think. You know, obviously, I think Wanderers were a bit sad, and I still get a few Wanderers fans, you know, saying, "Oh, are you coming back?" But it'd be a bit hard to leave now. So yeah, I think it was obviously I live in North Sydney as well, so it was sort of a part of the decision. But I think I'm just happy to be at Sydney now. So yeah.
Yeah, look, I think it's a no-brainer. You've made the right decision, but it might not be a big deal. But when you start playing for the Matildas, you'll be on the list of Wanderers ex-players. They wish they hadn't taken away. So, not a big deal so much now. But let me tell you, in the few years' time, they will be looking back as you being as one of the ones that got away. Talking of national team football, you represented Australia at under-20s and under-23 levels. And with the unbelievable season you've had, surely you're knocking on the Matildas' door. Has Tony Gustavsson been in contact with you? Has he sent you a message? Has he done anything? Because as the head coach of the Matildas, if it was me, I definitely would have reached out. So,
yeah, not personally, like not a personal interaction, but being a part of the under-23s was sort of obviously Mel is the head coach, who's the assistant. So I got to learn a lot about the senior setup. So it was sort of like a introduction for a lot of girls to what the senior setup is like. So yeah, I haven't had personal contact with him, but obviously being a part of future Matildas as well is, I'm sure a lot of the information getting fed down is sort of from him and what he wants. So yeah, I'd love to be a part. I love to play for Matildas. It's been a dream of mine since I think I started playing football. So yeah, I'm if it comes, whenever it comes.
When it comes. Your centre midfielder of a team has just won a double and had an outstanding season. So it's only a matter of time for you, Sarah.
Yeah, I mean, there's girls in the Sydney team that have, you know, also been doing consistently, and they sort of haven't got a chance. Yeah, I think looking at Courtney, that's sort of who I look to. I mean, she had, what, two or three, like, great seasons, and that's when she got into the Matildas. So, like, the Matildas is such a great squad. There's so many great players, and it's not easy to get in because all those girls were in the W League and having these great seasons as well. So, it's just sort of waiting for your time. And yeah, I love watching them play as well. So I love being a fan as well. So, obviously hope it comes, but yeah, not stressed about it.
Look, you keep being modest and I'll keep talking you up. That's fine. I think that's a good deal for everyone, right?
Yeah.
The Women's World Cup is here and in New Zealand in July, so it's super exciting that we have the best players in the world here on our shores. What will it do for women's football in this country?
I actually don't even know. I think it's going to be, I can't even sort of see how big it's going to get because I think it's going to be massive. I was at something with the Premier, and he sort of was doing an interview, and he sort of said this is going to be the biggest sporting event since the 2000 Olympics in Australia. So I think that is sort of how we can judge it. I think it's going to be massive, and we're sort of already seeing the the impact already. You know, Matilda's games are having great crowds. We just had a record crowd at our grand final. So it's sort of already getting the buzz. And I think it's the main thing is the young girls and seeing how they know all these Matilda's names. They know Courtney Vine, they know Jada, they know Prinny. And that's the big thing, because once you learn these personalities, you become attached and you want to follow these girls, you know, on and off the pitch. They're such great role models, and I think having female role models for young girls is going to be massive. You know, when I was younger, I didn't really know any female footballers. So I think having those role models and inspirations is going to be the biggest part. And then you're going to see, you know, the growth within the game, especially in the girls. And yeah, I'm super excited to see where it goes, because I'm still 19 and I'm still a fan of the game, and I still want to see it grow and see people, you know, see people enjoying the female football side, because I've seen the growth within the last 5 years in the quality. And I think there's so many great athletes and so many great people within the game that I just want to see more people seeing that as well. So I'm super excited.
You have tickets to the games?
Yeah, I do. Me and my brother were on our laptops ready to get them. We got them on the last drop. So, yeah, we've got games for the first game and a few other games. So, yeah.
I've been sitting there, considering you've just won a double, right? So you're not far off it, and you're going to sit there watching the game. So it will be a unique experience.
Yeah, no, I think I just love football. So I sort of take myself away. I sort of have my play side and my fan side. So I sort of don't even think about, oh, like, that's my teammate. I'm just enjoying the game. And, yeah, it'll be super cool. I hope Courtney is there, and I know she should be there. So and she's a great person, so she deserves, and she works so hard. So it would be great to have a friend on the pitch that I can sort of root for, and then also the whole Australian setup. So yeah, it's exciting. I'm super excited to watch.
Who do you favour to play the Matildas in the final?
Well, I don't know, the draw, obviously, it's like, who can they play? I think they potentially will
take that out of the equation. Who do you like? Who do you think plays? if you when you watch them, obviously being a player, yeah, but still a fan when you're watching that, which team do you love to watch other than our girls?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, USA, I love they're just like that mentality. I think they're just killers, and they just go into every game, you know, with the intent to destroy their opponent. And I love that, because I feel like the Matildas have that same mentality, and it would be great to see them sort of verse off. I love England as well. I think everyone's sort of grown to love them with the Euros. So, yeah, I'm Italian, so if Italy get there, it would be good as well, but I don't think they would. But, yeah, I think USA and Australia would be a really good game.
I've got Italian background too, but at least they've made the World Cup, unlike our men's team. So it's a good start,
it's great,
right?
To see. Yeah, it's a good start.
All right, let's get into one of the first two games I like to play with my guests. It's called Six Aside. Usually I compare you and your Sydney FC teammates, but I'm going to do a slight spin on this game, and we can make these sort of exceptions for champions. You can select any current teammate instead of the usual matchup. So you just tell me which player you think's most applicable for each of these categories. You ready to play?
Yeah, I'm excited, yes.
Who is most likely to pick up the team bill? So if you go to a breakfast or you go to a team lunch and the bill was there and everyone's sort of looking around to see who's going to pay, who's more than likely going to jump up and say, no problems, I'll take the bill?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I feel like I don't actually – maybe Nat, because she's the captain, but
I can see that. I think she'd step up for sure, yeah.
Yeah, I think she'd step up and sort of just be like, pay me back later, you know. You know, she's the leader here. So, yeah, I think Nat, and she's obviously always thinking about us girls. So if maybe we weren't able to pay the bill or something, she'd definitely step up for sure.
Look, it's tricky when you've got a young squad, right, because you still haven't made all your money. So it's a lot harder than when you've got a lot of senior
cards
players.
Cards are declining. Cards are always declining.
I know.
Yeah.
Who would do the best job minding my kids or my two dogs? So I've got two labs. Who would do the best job?
Look, I'm going to say two, Courtney and Charlotte, I think. Dream duo there. I think they're both so caring and would do a great job. I remember my first training session, they both came up and said hi. And yeah, Charlotte's just honestly one of the nicest people I know, and Courtney also so caring, and always thinking about all the girls. So yeah, I think they'd be great parents and dog parents. So yeah, and they have a dog as well, so they'd be used to it.
All right, so if I need a dog sitter or a babysitter, I can drop your name and say, Sarah's told me you're the go-to women. Is that
how it goes? Yeah. Yeah.
All right.
You can quote me.
Who has the best dress sense? I know this might get you in trouble, but I'm happy to help you out here if I have to. If I get any calls, I just say I'll put you on.
I'm going to say Prinny.
Okay.
She's just got style. She's got, rocks it, confidence. So, yeah, I'm going to say Prinny. She's got, you know, Sunny's going. Definitely.
From the outside, I couldn't disagree. When you see her, she's got this swagger about her, and she's overconfident, but she just seems confident enough that she can get the job done. So, yeah, definitely I agree with that.
Yeah.
This one could ruffle a few feathers with your teammates, but the good thing is it's off season, so you won't see them for a few weeks, maybe. Yeah. Who is the most high maintenance?
I'm going to say Kirsty.
Okay. Can you give us an example? What makes us? How can we get the feeling that she's the most high maintenance in the squad?
I don't know. Just, you know, the hair. She's got to straighten her hair sometimes. You know, can't go out, whatever. But yeah, more that she's just like always. You know, there's always something going on with her that she's got to have something going. But Kirsty, she just is high maintenance. Not in a bad way, but
lock it in.
Yeah. I'm gonna lock it in because she's one of my good friends as well. So
all right.
Hopefully she doesn't kill me.
Who sucks up to the coach the most? Could be to Ante, could be the whole coaching staff. There's always someone, even if you're a good friend, you just think, why do you go that extra mile? You don't need to, you're a good player, you're already gonna play anyway, but
yeah. I don't actually know. Like, I feel like we have like no one that's a big suck up. Like,
let's flip it then, Sarah. Is there someone in there that you could say definitely rule out instantly? Definitely not. They do not ever try and do anything nice for the coach. They just beat their own drum.
Yeah, I'd say Charlie. Like, there's so many times like Charlie, like, because she plays right back. You know, Ante will like be telling her things and Charlie will just be like ignoring him. So, and even when Ante speaks to her, she's like, yeah, whatever. Like, that's just so Charlie. She's just, doesn't care what anyone says. You know, she's just going with her own flow. And, I sort of admire her for that. She's super funny because she's sort of in her own world as well. So she's just doing what she wants. And, you know, if people like it, then great. If they don't, then she's not going to change for them. So, yeah, Charlie, I'd say Charlie.
You need some of those players in the squad as well as the ones who do what the coach wants. And the last one, who is most likely to be late to training or to the airport for an away game?
I feel like it's me kind of or Tegan as well. We're sort of
both. Did you throw yourself under the bus just then?
Yeah, because I like set the wrong alarm, like, because we train pretty early, like get up at whatever. I set the wrong alarm, like, usually we get there at 6. I set a 6 a.m. alarm, so I don't know, like, my brain wasn't working. I set a 6 a.m. alarm. Lucky I'm not too far away, so I just made it. But yeah, I'm gonna throw myself under the bus because no one else during the season. I still train, but Tegan as well missed the first half of a session as well, so they're guilty this season, but there's always one or two in a season. I think Rachel like slept through a session last year as well. So there's always like one a seasons, but I'll take it this year.
All right. You're a good teammate. All right, let's get into the second game we like to play with our guests, which is called 1-2, where you give us your thoughts on the following topics. You ready to go?
Yeah, I'm ready.
What song best describes you?
Oh, that's a good one. I'm going to say Don't Stop Believing. Don't stop believing. Hold on to that feeling. Because I love that song. Not really.
Okay.
I love the show Glee when I was like younger, and that song always stuck with me. And I think I sort of I used to listen to it all the time, but now whenever it comes up, I just, you know, it reminds me of the journey so far, and the lyrics are really sort of stick with you as well. So I'm going to say that it just sort of represents, you know, the life of an athlete as well. So yeah, I think that's a good one.
Your favourite Sydney FC men's player?
Oof. I'm going to say Luke Braddon, definitely, because he plays a similar position to me, and he's also a great guy off the pitch. You know, he's always coming and having chats, and he's got daughters as well. So I think he's sort of wanting to help the female side, and it's great to see he's, you know, always, you know, asking about games, sending messages, and yeah, he's a great guy and a great player as well. He's so composed on the ball, and yeah, I love watching him play. So it just runs the show.
Yeah, I'll back that one. When we did the Sydney Derby cook-off last year, he took his shirt off, signed it, went to the car, got a different one to put on and gave it to my son. So I know he's an absolute legend on and off the pitch. So, yeah, I can lock that one in with you.
Yeah.
The gaffer, Ante Juric.
Mm. Oh, he's like a teddy bear. We always say this. He's like a big teddy bear. Like, I always show, like, my friends, like, oh, yeah, this is my coach. And they're like, oh, he looks a bit scary. But because he's so, like, big and whatever. But he's literally like a BFG, what's it, big friendly giant. So he's just super chill, but motivating, like gets the best out of you, and without, you know, yelling or screaming, just, you know, sort of hits the spot with what he says. So
and a winner. He's got a lot of silverware when he was at Olympic, and as well as with your team, he's a winner. So
you want a coach that you can put 100% belief into what he's doing and the process he's doing. So it allows the team to sort of just play to their full ability, because they know sort of they've got a coach that you believe in on the sideline. It really helps.
Celebrity crush.
I was just watching Wrexham and like Ryan Reynolds. He's just like, he's obviously like really good looking, but like really funny as well.
Like
I didn't realize how fine he is. He's like a stand-up comedian wherever he goes. But yeah, he's definitely one, I think. And who else?
If you like Ryan Reynolds, there's a show you can check out on Netflix called My Next Guest Needs No Introduction with David Letterman, who used to be
a host.
And he had him on. He was fantastic, absolutely fantastic.
I haven't watched his one.
Yeah, with Blake Lively, his wife, and that. He was excellent. He was really fun. So if you are a big fan of his, you should check it out.
Yeah, I've seen a few episodes, but not Ryan Roslin. So I'll look at that one. But I just love everything about him. Yeah.
So if Wrexham, if he gets a women's team up and running for Wrexham, we know where you're moving to, right?
Yeah, exactly. Like fifth tier, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you talented at any other sports?
I've played so many sports. I don't know. I'm talented. Yeah, I don't know. I think I played. What did I play? I played like cricket. I played touch footy, surfing. I still surf a lot. So lots of sports. I love loads of sports. Surfing is the main one, I'd say. I mean, I'm not a star surfer, but I do it in my spare time and I love it, and Charlie and I surf all the time together, so that's definitely talented, because I've been doing it for I don't know how many years now, but because I only get to do it maybe once a week or something with training, but surfing, I'll say surfing.
Okay. Best player you've ever played with or against?
That's a good one. I think, at the World Cup, at the Youth World, under 20s World Cup, the Spanish striker, she scored a hat trick against us, but she was so great. Like, as a striker, she just scored with, like, she might have had three touches and she scored, just clinical. I think she was really good to watch. And then I think Madison Haley as well. She's insane, honestly. Like,
she's fantastic.
She is a weapon. Like, I remember at training, like, just watching her, like, for the first time, she can just turn, like, I've never seen anything, like, anyone before. Like, she's sort of got everything. She can finish. She can dribble. Like, she's so strong. Like, she just dominates, like, every player she plays against. So, yeah, I think Maddie is sort of one that I'm like, wow, like every time I watch her play,
I do too. And the last one, something you've always wanted to do but never tried yet.
Yeah, skydiving. I definitely want to do that.
Are you daredevil?
Yeah, a bit. I mean, like, I just love that, like, adrenaline. Like, we went go-karting the other day and I was just like, it's just so good to be in that, like, that zone. I love it. And then surfing is where you get that adrenaline with surfing. So, yeah, I want to go skydiving. And also I just want to, like, travel a lot as well. I just want to, like, see different things.
What's on the top of your list of travel destinations?
Yeah, Europe, I think. I think the history there and the culture is, something I always, like, am fascinated by. I went to Europe. We went to Italy with my family when I was younger, but obviously that was just around, like, visiting family, so it wasn't that not great, but it was still great, but it wasn't, you know, getting to see all the cool places. But, yeah, I want to go definitely through Europe and Africa as well, I think. I just want to see different cultures. I think so cool meeting different people from different places. And whenever I, like, hear someone with an accent, I'm like, oh, so interested in where they're from and life, the different life they live. So, yeah.
I'd say it's pretty safe to say that your next trip could not just be a holiday, it could be a working move. So I see a Europe move for you in the future if you keep going the way you're going. But, look, I thank you very much for your time. I know it's been a very busy couple of weeks and I know you've been celebrating, so I really appreciate you taking the time out to chat with us. It's added a bit of style and a bit of class to the show, so we're very grateful for that. I wish you all the best with off-season and having a bit of a rest and catching up with family and friends, and also hope you enjoy the Women's World Cup. But thanks again for being on the Football Revolution, and we'll check in with you again later in the year.
Yeah, thanks so much for having me. Great to chat, and some great questions there as well. Hopefully my teammates aren't too upset. But, yeah, thanks so much for having me.